Hiramaza, also a finisher. 67% by knockout, 6-3 in pro kickboxing. Also holds a jiu-jitsu purple belt under Damien Meyer. This one promises a lot.
Yeah, this is a very interesting matchup. We got that striking style from Mazar against Miura's grappling. Miura has got one trick, but it is a nasty one. She's gonna try to grab you by the neck, throw you on your back, and lock up that arm with a beautiful scarf hold key lock finish.
We got Chonin in the corner of Ayaka Miura. They call her the zombie. The 29-year-old out of Saitama, Japan. Aira, the Brazilian based out of Evolve MMA in Singapore. Stuffs the Italian takedown attempt. Good hook on the can there from Mazar.
His hands come lightning fast. As soon as they find an opening, Miura left her head open just a little bit, and immediately Mazar teed off on him.
Mazar, four-time Brazilian national standard champion, Pan-American standard champion, Wenko kickboxing brown belt. 6-3 kickboxing.
This is what Miura wants. Miura wants to try to take her right arm and wrap it around the body of Mazar. So you can see just how tightly Mazar is wrapping up that right arm. You can see now she's going the other way. Now she's trying for that headlock takedown. So she kind of gets it with a sacrifice. Now this is exactly where Miura wants to be. Look at her locking up this key lock. That arm is in danger right now. Miura's going to apply that pressure. And you're going to tap or you're going to snap.
This is Ayaka Miura's territory. It's Miuraville. She goes to work on the arm, and usually she takes it home inside of two rounds. Will she take home the arm? Will she choke out? Miyamazan.
Not a choke yet, Michael. She's attacking the arm in a Kimura position. She's going to try to take that left arm and shove it between her legs and force a lot of torque on the elbow, but that position also gives her an arm triangle too. If she takes her body and goes underneath that arm right there, she can actually sink up a nasty arm triangle, which she's done in the past as well.
Miura in control, top position here.
See, that's what she's going for right there. She's trying to push that arm up against the side of her neck, and she's gonna drop her body down to the floor. Now here comes that squeeze. This is a third degree black belt squeeze you got right there.
Judo black belt, top position. Ayaka Miura turning. Azar defending, but their faces turning a shade of deep red now. Miura looking for another first round finish to go 3-0 here in one championship. Mazar defending, grit and determination on Maeda Mazar.
That's two nasty submissions that Miura's got. How tough is Mazar to last this long in two deep submission attempts? That purple belt is being tested right now.
Miura is just phenomenal. She will never give in. She will always apply the pressure, and she'll keep squeezing and squeezing here. Never won by knockout or TKO. All her finishes have been by submission. The last two by a key lock in one round and the second round against Samara Balin and Samara Santos.
Look at her in transition. She realizes she's not going to get it. She still wants this first round finish. She might try to attack that leg lace key lock, but she might try to take that arm, apply it in there. This is a bad spot for Mazar to be in. If she doesn't get the finish, she's going to lose a lot of energy being in these submissions, trying to hang on.
And I'll tell you what, a win here tonight in fashion for Miura. Sends a big message for the strawweight champion, Jong Jin-nan.
A little bit of adjustment, but I don't think this is going to do it. I think, you know, sometimes you just can't choke people with certain positions, and I think there's just too much space between the other arm, that left arm, and maybe the neck. She's squeezing, she keeps trying, but she just can't quite get it.
And Mazar, see out the first round, 30 seconds to go. Miura needs to reset. This diabolical Japanese woman who has torn through the opposition so far. Took only 1 minute 13 to finish Laura Balin. Balin took Zhong Jin-nan 5 rounds.
Royal Chonan just saying, beat her up. Just land some ground and pound, do some damage. And Miura is doing just that. Right before the finish of this first round, she's landed a little bit of ground and pound, soften up Mazar just a little as she gets ready for that second round.
It was all about survival for Maeda Mazar of resume.
Look at that. Oh, rattled the chin of Miura, but then Miura does what she does. Gets that clinch, found a way to get the headlock takedown. You can see right here she starts going for the key lock, shoving that leg right between the legs of herself. She triangles them and puts a lot of torque on that shoulder. You can see the pressure being applied right there, but the position was a little bit awkward. And I think that's when Mizar was able to use just that awkward position to make sure she lasted that submission attempt. But then being stuck in the arm triangle of Miura for about 2 minutes or so was a long time to be choked. But those are two of the best moves that Miura's got. Can she do anything else?
Don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms at One Championship on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube. Filling up inside the Impact Arena in Bangkok, Thailand, for the first One Championship event of 2020. You're watching the second match of our lead card.
You can see the swelling start to develop on the left side. Beautiful shots just like that. She's got a beautiful little right hook that she throws. Mizar is able to land it. Miura's just eating it. She's got to be careful to keep those hands up as she starts to shoot. She shoots, chains up to the top, and she got that clinch. That's exactly what she wants. Look for the headlock takedown or possibly a judo throw.
Dominant first round from Ayaka Miura. One time attempting the submission on Miura Mizar.
Mizar is defending that headlock. You can see that Miura wanted to wrap up the head with her left arm. She's looking for the headlock takedown now, but Mizar was able to defend for a little bit. Driving that head in, there's a good position to defend against this headlock takedown that Miura is known for.
Mizar does have an 8-centimeter reach advantage over Miura. No chance to use it at the moment. I'd like to see her get some distance and work that striking of her 6-3 pro kickboxing record on Ayaka Miura.
Mizar is sitting down to avoid the headlock. She might sit down a little too far. The balance shown by her so far as Miura's going takedown again. That's a different way to do it. She just sits down and lands right into the headlock as well. She's doing the same thing that she's trying to do, she did in the first round. She's got a headlock. You can see how Mizar has wrapped up her leg around the leg, so she might be able to slide out, which is like one of the first escapes that they teach you in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu class, is how to escape a headlock. And this is one of the ways that they do it. Let's see if she can do it. They just go around, they try to sneak around the back, they try to pop their head out, so she ends up taking the back. Miura loves this position. She loves to grab hold of that head and just sort of hold people there looking for those submissions. One was the scarf hold key lock, which we saw in the first, and then she transitions to the arm triangle.
2 minutes 45 remaining, second round of three. First round was all Ayaka Miura on the ground over Brazil's Maeda Mazar. Leg of Miura is Mazar from bottom position.
You can see Mizar is trying to sneak around and take the back. She's trying to go. There she goes, creates a scramble, but she might end up in a little bit of a worse position. Yep, this is exactly what Miura wanted. She's going to try to take that left arm, shove it down between her legs, and look for that key lock again. You can see that Mizar is very, very comfortable on the ground. She's doing all the right things. She's very tough, so you can probably tell that she's been in a lot of grappling exchanges where she's been put into bad positions over there at those world champions in all mixed martial arts. There's that key lock, though. Was she tapping or slapping her in the face?
I believe she tapped her out there. It's another submission in the second round for Ayaka Miura. 3-0 now with One Championship. No one has lasted past the second round with her. Miura saying it would not take long. Santos saying that she'd outstrike her. And we're on the ground in the opening 7 seconds.
Yeah, just like that, she immediately gets that takedown. You can see what she's going for. She's trying to key lock that arm. So she's going to try to take that arm. She's going to try to shove it between her legs and put a lot of torque on that shoulder right there. She loves this headlock position.
We just saw the women's strawweight world champion in the corner of Muhammad Ayman in our last contest. You know that Zhong Jinan is keeping a close eye on this one, especially on Ayaka Miura.
Miura's trying to take that left hand. She's trying to shove it in between her legs. Santos has got to get very tight. She's got to go T-Rex on her arm. She's got to pull her elbows into her body and stay right there. She cannot allow Miura to take her left arm and shove it between her legs.
Ayaka Miura, 8-2-1 record, 4 submissions, 50% finishing rate, the third degree judo black belt. 12-6-1 record on Santos with 6 knockouts and 2 submissions, a 67% finishing rate.
You can see that Santos is trying to tie her up there, trying to go inverted, trying to sneak out the back door, so he might be able to snatch up a triangle. Look, she's almost got it. Yeah, she's almost got that triangle right there wrapped around the head of Miura. There's a submission here, possibly, if Miura doesn't let go of that head and defend this triangle.
The BJJ purple bounce, Samara Santos putting the pressure on Ayaka Miura with 3 minutes 20 remaining. First round set for 3.
Wow, Santos able to sneak out the back door and wrap up a triangle.
And troubles Miura in here, Dragon.
She's kind of just uncomfortable. You can see that the choke's not really in. It's kind of a very difficult position, but Santos might be able to use this position to sweep or reverse the position and get Miura off the top of her. You can see what she's trying to do. She's trying to grab her leg and trying to pull her, but she can't quite get that position down. Miura's heavy on top. Now she's dropping knees to the head here. Gotta be careful with the back of the head, though.
Pulled that glass down wisely there, did Miura. She saw the back of the head of Santos exposed. Triangle still locked in though from the Brazilian. Been in this predicament a long time now.
Miura's trying to throw those knees, trying to break up that grip. Look, she's gonna have to do something else because of the way that Santos has got her head positioned. You can see that Miura's knee in the back of her head like that. So Kemp Chang gave her a little bit of a warning on that. But a beautiful defensive strategy from Samara Santos to reverse that headlock position into a reverse triangle.
We're on the floor inside the opening 7 seconds of the round. We've been there since. It started well for Miura, but Samara Santos turned the tide by locking in this triangle. More knees coming here from Miura.
It's going to be really difficult for Miura to get out of this. Look at the way Santos has got her arm through Miura's arm, and she's grabbing her own leg. That's keeping it nice and tight. She's trying to adjust the triangle, make it a little bit tighter. But it's just a really uncomfortable position for Miura. I don't think the choke is quite in, but she's able to hold her. You can see Miura might be able to pop her head out. She's trying, but Santos has got that vice-like grip around the head. Miura.
If you're wondering whose hand that is in this ball of twine, the red nail polish does belong to Samara Santos. Knee there from Miura. 1:05 remaining in this first round. Mitch, take us through this again. Look at this.
You can see that Santos has her right arm wrapped around the leg there of Miura, and that's what the headlock was initially in with that head, with that arm. And then Santos went up the back door, wrapped her legs around, and slowly sunk in a triangle. Now she's starting to create a little bit of an angle, and now she's trying to turn. She can't pull down too much. She's got to adjust her right leg, so she has to take that shin and pull that shin down and adjust the position. Miura might be able to pop her head out here if she steps over. Now she's more and more south. Yep, there she goes. Now she's able to get her head out.
The question is, though, how much did that position for that long a time drain Ayaka Miura?
I don't think it drained Miura much. I think she was okay. She's comfortable. She's spent a lot of time in these types of situations over the past 12 years where she's been grappling. But you got to wonder, did he pass out the legs of Santos trying to squeeze like that? It'll also be interesting to see how the referees score that position.
Tremendous opening round. Lot to analyze, lots to look at. And how about Samara Santos? That triangle was on for a long, long time. It's all part of one championship. Dawn of Heroes live from Manila in the Philippines, inside the mighty Mall of Asia Arena, where tonight we will be sold out on a rainy night outside in Manila. And They entered the stadium, you know, Mitch, when we entered the stadium, we came here about 3.5 hours ago. There was already a line snaked around the front of the building. Incredible sights here in Manila.
It is a massive mega event here in Manila. And we're just getting started, ladies and gentlemen. You do not want to miss this card. But right now, we've got a very interesting matchup on our hands. I actually didn't think Santos was going to be able to get out of that headlock and that scarf hold position that Miura locked up.
Second round set for 3x5. Let's see if Samara Santos, who said she's been working predominantly on her kickboxing, especially the boxing, can get some strikes off now. Shoots in early, does Miura, takes it down to D's, looks to go to side control, gets there now.
Yeah, you can see Santos immediately wraps up her head, so Miura's gonna possibly try to switch positions, switch her hips, which means she's gonna change the sides of where her legs are on and bring that left leg a little bit closer to the head. Yep, that's what she did right there. And now she's back into that scarf hold position. She's gonna try to attempt a key lock, which is what she was trying to do in the first part. Now that hand is almost through the legs there. But you can see exactly what Miura wants to do. She's trying to wrap up that arm, sink in that key lock from that scarf hold position. And she goes.
It's yet another victory by submission for Ayaka Miura. Two. Miura comes out probing. Southpaw stance on Balin early. Angle up against the ropes here. Nice short knee on the inside there from Miura.
That underhook, pay attention to that. Let's see if she can slide those hips in. Balin's got to be very careful to keep that distance. That right arm is pushing on the hips to create that little bit of space. Oh, nice little headlock. Oh, that's it. Beautiful takedown from Miura. Now she's in that headlock right there. Watch this, put down that arm. She's going to try to kimura it. Possibly here, she might go for a scarf hold, which is a kimura with the arms, or with the legs, rather.
Early judo styling from the third degree judo black belt. Miura in the opening round here. Balin having a hard get-go at it. Nice hands to the top of the head there from Miura. Really cuts the hip in here again, just punches to the top of the head, then the nose of Laura Balin. Where does Balin go from here, Dragon?
Balin has an opportunity to get the back. She's trying to take her right leg and hook the leg of Miura, but she's having a hard time doing it. Now she's trying to go belly down. Miura's trying to scarf hold. Yep, that's what that is right there. Uh-oh.
And she's done it again. How about that? Another scarf hold finish.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.